when we consider required material, then carbon dioxide, as considered the overall reactions of photosynthesis, carbon dioxide plus water, the product is glucose, water in the form of vapor, and oxygen in the form of byproduct. When we consider overall reactions, then carbon dioxide, water, chlorophyll, light. So there are four required material. That is required material. It is the material which is required to complete the photosynthesis process. First, carbon dioxide, and their source, that is the atmosphere, plant, the green plant taking carbon dioxide from the atmosphere through the stomata. It is already well known facts which discussed in very lower classes, that is the stomata, which help in the exchanging of gases, water vapor, etc. Next to carbon dioxide, that is the water and minerals. Water and minerals is also called sap. And its source, that is the soil. Plant taking water and mineral or sap from the soil are through the roots. And the third, that is chlorophyll. It is the green photosynthetic pigment. Photosynthetic pigment. Its function is to trapping light, expelled electrons. So light energy trapping by the chlorophyll, and during the course of trapping, its electrons expelled, which breaks the water. So here light energy change into chemical energy. So it is very vital pigment present in the chloroplast. So its source, the green parts, and we consider here only green parts, not only leaf, all green parts, but leaf is the main parts, because number of chloroplast per unit area is more in the leaf with respect to the other parts. So it is the green parts. And the fourth, that is the light. It is essential to note here, that is the light, not some light only, it is the light. Any light of wavelength, any light of wavelength 400 nanometer at 2700 nanometer, it is the proper optimum wavelength for the photosynthesis taking place by the green plants. So these wavelength of light, these range of wavelength of light provided by any source of light, it is not limited to sunlight. So all the four are essential required material. But when we consider the raw material, then out of these four, only two material is raw material, that is the carbon dioxide and water. Carbon dioxide and water is raw material because both of them are used by the process in the form of reactant. Because carbon dioxide and water both are used in the process, reduced together and to form glucose. So carbon dioxide and water reducing into the glucose, so both of them are called raw material. But during the course of reducing process, that is light and chlorophyll minerals all are the helping material. So all of these are called required material, but not said to be raw material. So conclusively we say all raw material are required material. But all required material not said to be